morning, welcome, St. Mary. The entrance and phone can be found on page 817 of Breaking Bread in the Blue Finders. Today is the obituary memorial of St. Paul Miki and his companions, all martyrs for the faith. Today's mass is being offered for John D. Nichols, Jr., a priest to keep in God and Linda Nichols. Please rise for your celebration and evening and respect the entrance and phone. The souls of the saints are rejoicing in heaven, the saints who follow the footsteps of Christ, and since for love of him they shed their blood, they now exalt with Christ forever.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words and what I have done and what I have failed to do through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, strength of all the saints, who through the cross were pleased to call the martyr St. Paul Miki and companions to life, grant, we pray, that by their intercession we may hold with courage even until death to the faith that we profess. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, through the law I died to the law, that I might live for God. I have been crucified with Christ, yet I live, no longer I, but Christ lives in me. Insofar as I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God, who has loved me and given himself up for me. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Those who sow in tears shall reap rejoicing.
Those who sow in tears shall reap rejoicing.
When the Lord brought back the captives of Zion, we were like men dreaming. Then our mouth was filled with laughter, and our tongue with rejoicing.
Those who sow in tears shall reap rejoicing.
Then they said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us. We are glad indeed.
Those who sow in tears shall reap rejoicing.
Restore our fortunes, O Lord, like the torrents in the southern desert. Those who sow in tears shall reap rejoicing.
Those who sow in tears shall reap rejoicing.
Although they go forth weeping, carrying the seed to be sown, they shall come back rejoicing, carrying their sheaves.
Those who sow in tears shall reap rejoicing. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had ordered them. When they saw him, they worshipped, but they doubted. Then Jesus approached and said to them, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always, until the end of the age." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Go, therefore, and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. That's what we do, and that's what Paul Miki and his companions did. To go out and to teach by word and example, to have children baptized in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. My brothers and sisters, the Church celebrates this obligatory memorial of St. Paul Miki and his 25 companions. Those that made up these companions of Paul Miki were Jesuits, Franciscans, and laypersons, doctors and catechists, and all involved in promoting the faith, what we understand as evangelists. Paul Miki, being a Jesuit himself, in this time of the mid-1500s, in the area of Japan, Nagasaki, and they went to preach Christianity. And as you can tell, their lives were taken for that. It is really the beautiful seed of the martyrs that you and I stand on their shoulders as they have already made a path. It's these men and women who have gone before us. Like Paul Miki and his companions, but like our parents and our godparents, like our grandparents and their parents, all paving the way, everything that we do and say. It's important today that we have to understand, and we have heard this many times when various missionaries come to parishes throughout the U.S. and tell all of us that we are missionaries as well. And sometimes we say, maybe you are Father, or maybe you are Sister, but I live here. This is mission territory in the U.S. Everywhere, the gospel can never be taken for granted. Even in our own families, among our friends, whom we thought would absolutely hand on the faith, a great responsibility, isn't it? To hand on the faith, to have children baptized and reared as Catholics, to have them experience religious formation and education, preparing them for their first penance and first Holy Communion and confirmation, to allow them to understand the mysteries of the sacraments, the role of Mary in salvation history, to learn and listen to the lives of the saints, to hear the stories of their grandparents and their great-grandparents as they lived and sacrificed for the faith. Are they stories of yesteryear, long and gone? Or is there a responsibility among all of us to continue? continue to capture the Catholic faith that was given to us by Jesus himself, to have a renewed evangelization, to have a spark within all of us, an energy, that zeal like Paul Miki and his companions had. A great task, but they were up for the challenge, weren't they? God places various challenges before all of us, especially in our own country. Paul Miki had Nagasaki, we have the U.S. to promote Christianity. We have to be very careful because little by little, Catholicism is being sifted out of the U.S. Probably we would never think of that, right? We would never think of this. When I was a kid, we had over 350 parishes just in the Archdiocese. Today, 214. I don't consider myself an old man, but since I was a kid to now, that's a lot of parishes. Every parish had a parochial school. So there's now 214 parishes with 102 schools. When does this stop? The responsibility of all, the bishop, priest, deacons, laypersons, taking up the task of evangelization, working hard to promote the faith and to make sure that what has been given by many men and women through their time, talent, and treasures, not worried about so much buildings, but the faith that are contained in the buildings. We need buildings, don't get me wrong. This is a beautiful place. This is a beautiful campus. Beautiful school and hall and annex building, residence and office center. These are the sacrifices made by many people, including yourselves, that houses the content of the faith. Sure, where are the living stones? Absolutely. We are the living stones to promote all that is good, right, and just, and holy. Jesus told us, we just heard it in this Gospel of Matthew, go therefore and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. We will, Lord. We will take up the challenge that you told us to do. We're grateful for Paul Miki and his companions. We're grateful for John Neumann and Elizabeth Ann Seton. We're grateful for Mother Catherine Drexel. We're grateful for all these heroes and heroines like our moms and our dads who gave us the faith, who introduced us to Jesus, and who showed us by word and example who this Jesus was and who this Jesus is in our life. And our moms and dads told us that we are not just going to church. We are the church. This building is called a church for one reason and one reason only. Because it houses the church. It's called the church because it houses the church, the living stones. And it's here that we gather to hear the word of God, hear it preached and proclaimed, and then here to enter into the mystery of the sacrifice, the one sacrifice of Christ for all the sins of the world, as he offered himself with our sins to the Father. And that we join in this mystery, we enter deep into the mystery of faith as we place our lives, our sins, and our failings on this altar so we may be transformed. That Jesus removes the sins of the world. We're going forth now with lit lamps to greet the bridegroom in every day and every situation. And let us continue the task. Let us take up the journey. There is a mission for all of us. We are disciples in mission, called to take up this cross of Christ and to proclaim him everywhere. Let us never take it for granted, because when we take it for granted, we become drowsy. Remember the story or the parable of the 10 virgins? 5 were wise and 5 were foolish. Give us some of your oil for our lamps. No, because we may not have enough. Go to the merchants and get some yourself. Our lights must be always kept burning. That candle that was given to us in baptism from that beautiful Easter candle must always shine in a world that sometimes is very darkened by sin. But it's up to the Christians of today, like it was for Paul Miki and his 25 companions, to light the light of faith and to bring that faith to all they encountered. God does the rest. He sends us like the gospel says that the apostles were sent. Go. Go and do this work. And God sprinkles all this with grace so that everything we say and do may begin by him and by him be happily completed. After reflecting on God's holy word, let us now place these petitions before the Lord with confidence and trust.
For church leaders, may the Spirit of Christ sustain them in their lives of service. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For political leaders, may God bless them with integrity and humility. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer from anxiety or depression, may the hope of Christ bring peace to their lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those within our faith community who are discerning vocations to the priesthood and religious life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they enjoy eternal life through the mercy of our loving God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, Laura St. Bonet, Carolyn Stanger, Daniel Strinkowski, and all those on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for John D. Nichols, Jr., for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for the spiritual and temporal needs of St. Mary's Parish, so that all of us may further the mission of Jesus, like St. Paul and his companions did. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they are in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you. bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of his holy church.
Receive, Holy Father, the offerings we bring in commemoration of the holy martyrs, and grant that we, your servants, may be found steadfast in confessing your name. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the blood of your blessed martyr, Paul Miki, and his companions, poured out like Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear you witness through Christ our Lord. And so, with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end, we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant you peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Him, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
salvation of all. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the Word be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Have a nice day, everybody. St. Michael,
the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray, and his